is just fantastic.
Captain's log, subdate 210218.4. With the weapons tests complete, I've decided to get the warp engine online. Consider it a new task, and see if we can break a speed record for underwater travel. The current record is held by some poxy sperm whale, the same one that was following us when we started doing these captain's logs. Welcome everyone to the exhibition of stupid people. Today we have four subjects I'd like to go through, and we're going to start with the 2021 census. Every 10 years in the United Kingdom, we do one of these things. I'm not a fan of them for a number of reasons. The last time we did one, I was at university and I chose religion, Jedi. I'm not even a Star Wars fan, but I went with Jedi. This time though, things are a little different. And so I've seen a number of adverts here and there. Billboard signs, bus stop signs, adverts on YouTube as well. Indicating the importance of this census over all other censuses. The reason why is because of recognition of gender. Now, I take no issue with how you choose to identify yourself. Some of you will undoubtedly regret choosing, and then insert those pronouns here, I don't care enough. Others, though, are going to take this as an opportunity, one that others may well regret, i.e. those who sent out the census. It's when the message gets out that Apache helicopters need to assemble, like the Avengers. I wonder if that'll be recognized as a gender. I know that was, by the way, a joke from 5 years ago, but in retrospect, it's a funny one now, especially if enough people do it. Let's not forget here, there was a discussion as to whether or not Jedi could be considered a religion because of the number of people that put themselves as a Jedi in their religion. The stupid part, I guess, about this is the census itself. I have always been against it. Yes, we can get a rough estimate of the number of people, the identities of those peoples, those who are living, those who are not. Sure, but it does have inaccuracies. It doesn't take into account the homeless, for example. Anyone living in a shelter, they're not covered by the census. So to me, to do a census is redundant. I think it'd be much easier to slip a microchip in a vaccine at this point. And someone's going to get triggered now that I said that. It's a f***ing joke. Okay? I don't think anyone should be tagged at all. Unless you're in my ISO cubes. To move on from that, we're going to go with Disney and Gina Carano. Gina Carano, for quite some time, has been outspoken about, let's say, social justice. Let's go with that. She is on a side of an argument, and many don't agree with her. Wrongthink is the word many have used to describe this incident, by the way. Gina Carano was fired from Disney and the show The Mandalorian for making a comparison between political differences in America to the Holocaust. Now, this is a spicy take, I'll give you that. It is a false equivalence, of course it is. All comparisons to the Holocaust are false equivalences. And it is with that spirit in mind, I should point out that her co-star, former, Pedro Pascal tweeted this out back in 2018, since her past was being used against her by many to cancel her. Germany 1944, America 2018, Kids in Cages, which has been repackaged. It now has a nice, shiny name, Turd Polish. Fun thing here is, that bottom picture is not in America. In fact, that is Palestinian children waiting to receive food from a soup kitchen. Not even in America. But it's okay, everyone. Pedro Pascal is okay. He's safe. Because, not wrongthink. And of course, Disney don't cancel people for their past mistakes, do they? No! No, totally not. If you haven't seen the sarcasm sign, it's been on the screen the whole bloody time. Some did point out that because of this, you've actually done something quite stupid, in the sense that you've, while empowering women, you've silenced one. Which is to them, many, I find this quite fascinating too, a bit hypocritical. The only people you should be cancelling, for those who don't know, are those poxy, pesky, horrible, vindictive, straight white men. And there I was thinking that argument was dead from 2018, but apparently not. James Gunn, by the way, for those who don't remember, was cancelled for past spicy posts. For the sake of it, I don't agree in cancelling anyone.
I really don't. Gina Carano is a very talented actress, and if you want to have a go at her, she'll still knock your teeth out. Seriously, have you never seen Gina Carano fight? Her mixed martial arts background is quite something. To the penultimate subject, we go to a TV show called Married at First Sight. A more recent version or season of it aired on a channel called E4 recently, and one of the participants of the show, called Dan Webb, has received a bit of flack, a bit of criticism, from the trolls. These trolls, cough cough, are not overly fond of Dan Webb, so they've been criticizing him on all forms of social media. Dan Webb made two mistakes with this. The first one was responding. When a troll baits a hook, they bait it with the intention of making you look stupid. The mistake was when you took the bait, because then you made a mistake. While criticizing the trolls for their lack of grammar, I couldn't help but notice, and I'm sure the trolls saw it too, you made a mistake in yours. Right at the end, thanks, you're great. There's an E and an apostrophe missing from that. No doubt the trolls absolutely loved this. This is a very short one, by the way. I just want to point at Dan Webb and say, you're a moron. Also, why is there a space before and after a comma? Is that a social media thing? To the final subject, we're going to go to Def Noodles. See, Def Noodles is Big Brave. Made a video earlier in the week criticizing, well, a few people. He does it all the time in his very loud, obnoxious voice. Nothing wrong with that. It's just a character in satire, bro. But he criticized John Swan after Dream made a few accusations. He also called John Swan alt-right. You have a weird thing for calling people alt-right, especially when you provide your definition of it. This is the definition you've provided. It's fascinating because, based on the definition you've provided, anyone that criticizes these subjects is alt-right, which is really strange, because by doing that, you've now insulated those groups as being untouchable. And yet you have a commentary channel built on criticism. You have narrowed the field of what is acceptable for you to say. I guess that's the mark of a really progressive comedian, especially when you provide literature as a suggestion for people to read so as to best understand why there's a lining of truth to your accusations. No one's going to read it because your accusation holds zero merit and all you've done is show us where you've gotten your bias from. You're a terrible comedian. I would hate to be at one of your shows when you got heckled. And I know you've shown a little heckling in the past, but come on, you're not Isaac Butterfield here. You're no Jimmy Carr. You are, by comparison to any other comedian who would ride that wave and annihilate the other person, delicate. And we can prove this because the list of those you've blocked has gotten longer. I didn't know, by the way, you blocked Ricky Berwick. That was funny. Seriously, who blocks Ricky Berwick? But the more recent one is the one that annoys me. I get on really well with Ripzilla. I like his content. I like his style. I also really appreciate and respect the way he handles stands, fans, those who cross lines, and those he respects by giving them the same level of respect and criticism when they are right to receive it. Which is where you come in, Mr. Noodles. See, it turns out you really can't handle criticism of any kind. So you blocked Ripzilla. Which is really precious, because you added to this by going on your second account, which you claim to be your main account. That's a lie. It's just the account you use when you ditch a character. Air quotes around character. It's just satire, bro. It's a character. It's just a joke. You go on to the Go With Dennis account, and you subtweet Ripzilla by proving you are more of a bitch than anyone else. A little bitch. A stupid little bitch who can't handle criticism of any kind. You are pathetic. You rail on others with narrow-minded ideas. You jump to conclusions and show you lack even the slightest amount of talent when it comes to research. And your way of handling those now on Twitter, oh, but I have a legit reason to block them, I'm sure, just trust me, everyone, is proven to be lies when even those that support you say, you're wrong. But it's okay, you probably block them too. You are the 2021 version of Steve Shives. Congratulations. The only difference is you have more hair on your head than him. You are an absolute snowflake. And if the way you're going to handle yourself when it comes to commentary channels criticizing you is to simply find a way to scapegoat them, then don't be surprised if more and more of them rail on you for your absolute inadequacies. You should think smart here. yes, you're a growing channel and you're doing amazingly on numbers, but the more and more detractors there are, the more chance those viewers of your content will see their content. It's how I found out about anti-SJWs after I was recommended an Anita Sarkeesian video, a speech she gave. After watching it, I was recommended a whole list of videos debunking it. The same will apply to you, but I guess you don't care really. You gotta maintain that viewership, right? Why be a grown-up when you can just fob it off as comedy and act like a little prick? Anyway, as we're done here, I want to know what you think. Please do let me know in the comments down below. As a final thing, I'm going to be on Twitch tonight, streaming some murder fun time. If you're at all interested, it'll be linked down below. Hope you all have a fantastic day, and thank you all very much for listening.